Brett isn't in trouble, it seems like.
Well, Brett just said, yeah, I'll do that. And
the Mississippi Community Education Center seems like they're the ones that are going to have to answer some questions.
Go on. Why don't you tell them what happened, AJ, and your opinions and your thoughts and who's in trouble and who's not?
First off, these are all allegations. I don't know what's going on, but there was some audit done, and that's why I wrote it down. The Mississippi Community Education Center paid Brett $1.1 million. Is this still only 1 year? In 1 year they paid him this?
One payment was for 500 some thousand. Yeah. So I think it was a couple appearances worth a lot.
Yes,
of money.
For supposedly appearances, promotions, autographs, speaking gigs, and what they went and they did research through the audit, and they found that Brett was not there at any of these appearances and all this. But it got me thinking, couldn't this be a memorabilia deal? Like, I know even when guys are playing, they have memorabilia deals where they sign a certain amount of things throughout the course of the year, and they get a guy like Brett could easily say, okay, I'll sign however many items. I want 25 hours on a NetJet. Like, you could do that. Like, is this one of those deals?
Okay, good. Great point that I did not think about, by the way, because I had Panini or whatever. They sent me 2,000 cards or something like that, and I was getting a paid per card rate or whatever. And by the way, I did not finish all the cards I was supposed to because it was the most tedious shit of all time. And I signed a bunch, but there was a whole nother stack that was equally the same size, and I was like, my hands do get cramped while writing my name here. But that could definitely be the case. Now, granted, $1.1 million now, that means Brett negotiated a hell of a deal or he signed a lot of stuff, if that is what happened. And I bet you Brett and his agent are just looking at this like, hey, that's business, baby. And he did business with the Mississippi government. I would assume that whoever was negotiating these deals, maybe they were big fans of Brett and they were negotiating this deal so they could hopefully win over Brett's friendship and hang around them by paying him a gross amount of money. Or maybe Brett did sign a million things. Maybe Brett only did a dollar an autograph. We do not know, but it does seem as if the people that were giving the money were potentially doing something a little bit shady, because I guess there was other deals happening with cousins of said person that was making yep. deal.
Brother-in-law.
Yep. And after watching McMillions, it feels as if I'm a little bit more woke to these types of situations on how the kickbacks work and stuff like that. This is just the tip of the iceberg. I hope Brett Favre didn't do anything other than a good business decision for himself, but it does feel like the person that was sending said money to Brett is potentially in a little bit of hot water.
Yeah, it seems like it's playing out that way. And like you said, this is just the tip of the iceberg. But one of the things I read said Brett is not like facing criminal charges. I mean, worst thing that could happen for Brett, it seems like, is that he's gonna have to pay the money back
or lose his Copperfit endorsement.
No,
this is separate.
This is completely different. Diggs, don't you do what I think you'll do is you'll take some of his Copperfit money.
Oh, yeah.
And just say, Mississippi, how about we do this? You get 20% of the Copperfit elbow sleeves and knee sleeves. I keep the wrists, and then we'll be able to negotiate this whole thing back. You'll make more than $1 million. Have you ever seen us? We're in the As Seen on TV aisle in every fucking store. Brett Favre's face is basically the entire As Seen on TV aisle, and I'll be damned if I don't have enough vitamins. I will buy every one of them.
Is he still a Wrangler?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, if he wants. I mean,
a legacy at Wrangler.
He didn't have to do any more Wrangler, by the way, because the state of Mississippi was paying him $1 million. Yeah. So now he's going to get back into that game, probably. I like what Brett has done. And I like the fact that he can drive a golf ball 370 yards. Mm-hmm. So, I'm a big Brett Favre guy.
You know, people always ask, like, oh, what's Brett doing with that Copperfit stuff? And you just mentioned it. It's in every single store in America, at least, probably worldwide, in the As Seen on TV aisle. And there's multiple products, too.
Oh, yeah.
When you can get in all of those stores, like, Brett's got to be making so much money from that.
Yeah, he's going to be on Shark Tank. It's going to be on Shark Tank next to Lori, who's the QVC master. Brett's going to be up there. He's like, well, yeah, I threw footballs for a little bit. I signed autographs for the state of Mississippi. I sold Wranglers. And then where I really hit it big was, this fucking Copperfits are everywhere, and I just made $1 billion. So now I would like to invest in whatever the hell you got going on. And if it's a long-distance driver, sign me up, because I'll hit that sumbitch 600, 700 yards. Brett Favre is living his best life right now.
So you're saying, I thought you said he's going to take Copperfit to the Shark.
He's a shark. Are you kidding me? His autographs are worth $1.1 million. He is a shark.
Shock. That would be good TV to see Brett up there wearing a t-shirt and Wranglers and a hat next to all those rich people.
Shoot, I don't really know that stuff. I'm out. I love that show.
Look good, feel good. Feel good, play good.
Play good, pay good. Pay good, live good. Live good, die good.